Hello, this is a quick video to show my weekend project, and I call it the ad filter switch. You can already see we have two push buttons with indications. One is for ad filter, another is for internet. So when I press the ad filter push button, it will either enables or disables the network-wide ad filter, and I will get the confirmation in the form of this indication. Now the indication is glowing, meaning that my ad filter is enabled. And similarly for the internet, if I press the push button, and it will disconnect my internet connection, and it will glow, indicating that my internet connection has been disconnected. And now I'll quickly change my camera angle, and I'll show you a live demonstration. Okay, here we are. Now I have opened a open speed test tab on the Chrome, and now my PC is connected to the internet using Wi-Fi, so I am expecting a very low connection speed, maybe order of 2 or 3 Mbps. Now I am going to start the speed test. So it is showing connection speed test is coming. Now I press the internet push button, and you can see that my speed is gradually coming down, and this is already the connection has been terminated. The slowness is because of the open speed test website. And since now it will be now the download test has been completed, and still the internet connection is disabled, so it cannot do even upload test also. So once I press the internet button again, you can see that it started that upload test. Luckily I'm getting a very high upload speed. So this is how the internet push button works. Just hold on, I'll open another tab for checking the ad filter. Okay, here I have opened my local news website, and in place which it is supposed to show some ads, it is showing some blank space. Here also sometimes ads used to come. So you can already see that my ad filter is already enabled condition. So if I refresh the page with the ad filter disabled, you can see that here advertisements will be there. So now the ad filter is on. Again, I'm switching it off. That ad filter has been disabled. I now just refresh the page. Page is refreshing. And yes, it has already created a space for that. Yes, here also an ad has come. And here top also an ad has come. So that indicates that my ad filter is has been disabled. So this is the two major functions what these buttons do. Okay, I have made a small sketch to show the system parts, how they are working together. So I have the internet provided my ISP, and the ISP modem which is connected to my wireless router. So normally my connection between my ISP modem and wireless router will be enabled, so that all the devices in my network can access internet. So when I push the internet button in the when I push the internet button here, so what it does, this module or this system will communicate with my wireless router, and it will tell you stop the communication between the router and the modem. So this will connection will be disconnected, and none of the devices will be able to connect to the internet. And once it is again, when you push the button, it will tell again the wireless router to restore back the connection, so that every device in the network can get internet. And how the ad filter is working, I have installed a pi-hole DNS server. Please check in the links given in the description. You can know more about how the pi-hole works. So it will disable, or it will not allow any ad related content to pass through the wireless router to the internet. So when I press the ad block button, it will tell simply enable the pi-hole DNS server. So only non-ad traffic is allowed, and if any advertisement related traffic is coming through my network, it will just block that. Now we'll see what is inside my ad filter switch box. So you can see that this is a box, and yes, we have one instead of one on-off switch. I am providing a jumper wire temporarily, since I didn't add any on-off switch while I was making that. So this is what the ad filter switch is, and I will just open it. I already removed the screws, and moment I open it, you can see that heart of it lies one ESP module, ESP8266 module, and this is the ESP8266 module, and we have two AA batteries powering the system and some breadboard connections, and of course the push button switch along with the LEDs you can see here. So I'll just disconnect the power for a moment so that nothing happens bad. We take another drawing. I'll just show you how the systems, how the connections are really happening inside. So you have two AA cells powering the ESP8266, and you have the internet push button and the ad block push button. So this is how you are connecting the system. When you press the ad block push button or the internet push button, that it will be detected by the module, and it will send out some commands to the Raspberry Pi based Pi hole, and it will execute the commands, and it will either enables or disable the ad block, or it will enables or disable the internet. That wraps up my video, and I did not give that much detail about the configuration of Pi hole, because it was already done, and I did not do anything while I was doing this project. Only I just made some modification to the API that was provided by the Pi hole, and just that's it. If you like the video, please give us a thumbs up. Bye.